Hello friends, welcome back to Apple Friendly. Today I brought you the second part of iPhone privacy and security settings video. I am going to discuss few more privacy and security settings in this video. So without any further ado, let's get started. Before proceeding, if you missed the first part of this video, I'd recommend to watch it and I'd put the links in the cards as well as in the description below. And with that being said, let's look at some location and advertising settings. So, launch settings on your iPhone, scroll down and look for privacy. Select location services. Scroll down and hit system services. Now here, you need to make sure that unnecessary toggles are off. It all depends on personal choice, but if you don't understand much of the stuff, simply follow the same settings as I've shown here. I also keep all the product improvement features off, because I don't like sharing my personal information with Apple. You can decide as per your preference. Now scroll down and you need to make sure that the status bar icon toggle is on. This will help you to know which services are using your location in the background. Now scroll up and select this significant locations. Provide touch ID or face ID. And you should see the complete history of your location since the day you bought your iPhone. I'd recommend to first clear the history, confirm clear history, and then go ahead and put this significant locations toggle off. Now your iPhone will never track you. Now let's go back again, and under location services, select share my location option. Now put this toggle off if you're not using location sharing services in apps like Messages or Find My Friends. Now let's go back. And here you need to make sure that apps are not using your location unnecessarily if they don't need to. You can select the individual apps and provide the location access permission. Never is always better. Do this for individual apps. Now under same privacy settings, scroll down and look for analytics. And put this toggle off if you don't want to share the analytics data with Apple. This analytics data include the data related to iOS operating system and apps, like for example, crash reports of apps, location information, etc. I prefer to keep it off. You can decide as per your preference. Now go back and select advertising. Here, put this limit ad tracking toggle on and tap on reset advertising identifier and hit reset identifier. Now you should not receive interest-based ads. You'll still receive the same number of ads, but they won't be relevant to you. Now let us look at the settings related to Apple ID password. So tap on your name in settings. Select password and security. Now make sure that two-factor authentication is on and trusted devices and phone numbers are listed. This will add an additional layer of security every time you log into your Apple ID account. And if you wish, you can also set the recovery key for your Apple ID password for an additional security. Soon I shall be releasing a video explaining these features. Now last but not the least, let us look at some Safari browser settings. So select Safari in settings. If you use Safari as your default web browser on your iPhone, you need to adjust some settings for privacy and security purpose. Let's look at them one by one. First, tap this search engine option. Google learns and uses your browsing history for advertising purpose. If you wanna keep your browsing history private, you can use this DuckDuckGo search engine. It doesn't store or use your browsing history. Now go back, scroll down, and make sure that block pop-ups toggle is on. Now scroll down, and here you need to enable few privacy and security toggles on, like prevent cross-site tracking, ask websites not to track me, and fraudulent website warning. Now scroll down more, and clear history and website data. tap to confirm. You should do this on a regular basis. And this brings me to the end of the video. I hope this second part of privacy and security settings video helped. If you liked it, share it with your friends and loved ones. If you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing to the channel for more videos. I'll see you soon in the next one. This is Vikas signing off. Thank you so much for watching.